Hey everyone, today we're going to be talking about how to develop a trend following strategy for RBOB gasoline. So before we start, as always, I invite you to please subscribe to our channel, click on the notification bell and leave us a like to this video. Thank you so much. Hi, we are the Unger Academy and we teach traders how to make money in the markets. Our founder, Andrea Unger, had been struggling with trading for years until he developed his automated trading method, which he used to become the only four-time world trading champion. Subscribe to our channel for free tips and tricks. Okay, so let's start. Here's a 30-minute chart of the RBOB gasoline future. Now, we intend to buy and sell in favor of the trend on the previous session's highs and lows, which are these, for example, plotted in red and green, and they will be the entry levels of the strategy corresponding to this point here at the bottom, which is the low of the previous session, and this other point here at the top, which is the high of the previous session. And on these levels, we'll send our orders. Okay, so the entry rules are to enter long, as mentioned, when the previous session's high is exceeded, and then short when the previous session's low is exceeded. The session on this market starts at 6 p.m. and ends at 5 p.m. the following day, New York time. The time window, namely the trading window in which we'll place our orders, will start half an hour after the start of the session and end half an hour before the end of the session, always, of course, at New York exchange time. At most, the strategy will only be able to make one entry per day. This means that if we've entered, for example, long, then we won't be able to enter short until the next day. Also, since this is a multi-day strategy, it will keep positions open beyond the end of the session for a maximum of 5 days. Lastly, we have the standard stop loss and take profit exits, set at $1,500 and $5,000 respectively. At this point, once all the rules of the strategy are known, we can proceed to create the code. And to do this, we'll use our proprietary software called Composer, which in just a few clicks will provide us with a script that we'll then directly use in MultiCharts. So we're going to set up all the various inputs that we described earlier. The trigger will be the trend follower breakout on N sessions ago. How many sessions? One session in this case. As mentioned previously, the time window will start at 6:30 p.m. and end at half past 4 p.m. or 4:30 p.m. without a break, long and short. And we set to limit entries to a maximum of one per day. Now let's now go through the exits very quickly. As you see here, you can set whether the strategy should be intraday or multi-day. We decided to be at market for 5 sessions, so let's go and set the number of sessions here. And then we also decided to keep the stop loss active at $1,500. We didn't use the break even. And the take profit is at $5,000. Now there, at this point, we can click on Generate Code. And in a very few seconds, the Composer, it has already finished processing, and in the output columns, we'll see the results. We have our code all done, and we can safely copy and paste it inside the Power Language Editor. By simply pasting and compiling this strategy, we can now go and evaluate the results. Here I had already uploaded it, and optimize all the various inputs. And here are the results. Now the strategy has been uploaded. Let's go through the results, starting with the average trade, which as we know is one of the most important values when reading the performance report, which stands at about $146. A good proportion between long trades and short trades is very important when developing commodities. And the equity line also takes on a shape that certainly looks nice, considering that the strategy hasn't yet been optimized. And so the optimal points might even deviate a little bit from what we set in the Composer. So what we're going to do now is to optimize, for example, one of the many parameters that the strategy has. For example, the stop loss from $500 to $3,000 in steps of $100. So we initially set a stop loss at $1,500, but let's see if by setting a slightly larger or perhaps slightly smaller stop loss, the results can improve. Let's get the optimization going. And here are the results. What we saw before were the results with a stop loss at $1,500, and we had a net profit of about $258,000 and a drawdown of $42,000, and as mentioned, the $146 average trade. What can be noticed, however, is that as the stop loss increases, the net profit of the strategy also increases. And by the way, in some cases, the drawdown also decreases. So we certainly could think about using a slightly larger stop loss for this market compared to the one we had set. Now let's try to set it at $2,400, which seems to me a very good value. It also has an excellent net profit. So let's go and set $2,400 as the stop loss and see how the results change. Here in this case, you can see this trade that was before was unlucky and was immediately closed practically on the next bar. Now even reaches take profit. In the strategy report, the equity line has an even better shape than before, an indication that this strategy can be further improved and optimized. So, guys, give it a try too. And if there is someone among you who is interested in the world of systematic trading, I suggest that you go and click on the link in the description of this video. And from there, you can go and watch a video by Andrea Unger, and get our best-selling book by just covering the shipping costs, or even book a free call with a member of our team. And if you like this video, please be sure to leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and click on the notification bell so that you can stay updated on the release of all our new content. And with that, goodbye everyone, and we'll see you next time.